התוכנית משודרת במימון השבועון לילדים כולנו, עכשיו במתכונת גדולה יותר וצבעונית יותר. הגרלת פרסים בכל גיליון, להשיג בכל דוכני העיתונים.
You are the last electric knight. I give to you my power and my knowledge. You must carry on, but not alone. I have chosen this man.
Bad dream. Okay.
It was horrible. There was these big ugly guys with beards and motorcycles and horses.
Oh, that's all right. It's okay now. It's the last time I'm letting you watch Hill Street Blues before you go to sleep.
I don't think it was the show. I think it was the pizza.
Well, I got a nightmare of my own in about 4 hours. I got to go to court today. You think you're about ready to go back to sleep? Okay, come on. I'll tuck you in. You mind if I rack out here the rest of the night?
Okay.
You like that?
Okay.
All right. Here we go.
It's okay. I'll see. It's all right.
Tell us what you saw next, Sergeant Rizzo.
I saw the defendant, Mr. Sweeney, throw a bag of rare coins out the window.
Did you recover the alleged bag?
No.
Did you recover the alleged coins?
No. We think Mr. Sweeney had an accomplice in the alley.
Everything after no is non-responsive.
Sustained.
Did the defendant happen to tell you that he had thrown a bag of rare coins out the window?
Are you kidding?
Just answer the question, please.
No, the defendant did not tell me anything. But he did.
Then perhaps you'd be so kind as to tell us, Sergeant Rizzo, how you happened to know the defendant threw a bag of rare coins out the window.
He threw something out the window.
Something?
Coins. The owner said the coins were missing.
Objection.
Sustained.
The guy's a burglar. He's got a list of priors a mile long.
But no convictions. And I would again object, Your Honor.
Sustained. Sergeant Rizzo, prior arrests are not admissible. You should know that. And you should also know proper testimony technique.
Yes, Your Honor. I'm sorry, Your Honor.
No further questions.
You may step down.
Great.
Will counsel please approach the bench? Upon recommendation from the defense counsel and in concurrence from the county attorney, this case is dismissed. Lack of evidence. Next case.
Hey, tough luck, Rizzo.
I'll get you next time.
Yeah, well, there wasn't even a this time.
Let me tell you something, Sweeney. I may not be able to nail you in court, but you better pray you never run into me in the streets. You understand?
Oh, Sergeant Rizzo. Huh? Sorry about that. Some of my clients aren't very nice guys, but I've just got to do my job.
Meanwhile, another guilty man is out searching for his next target.
Well, he is innocent until proven guilty.
You're pretty slick, you know that?
Slick?
Yeah, slick.
I don't think I like being called slick.
Tough.
Why don't you buy me a drink and call me Captain?
You're really something, you know that? You practically undressed me in that courtroom, and now you want to get chummy over drinks?
Well, we do have to separate our professional lives from our personal lives, don't we?
Well, I do know a place in the next block, but they don't like lawyers, though. Why don't you just pretend to be human, all right?
Hi, Ernie.
Well, hello, Miss Rizzo. How was your day?
Terrific. Burglar got off, but I got a date out of it.
You're dating a burglar?
No, burglar's lawyer. He's terrific. Bright, beautiful. Everything I hate in a lawyer and love in a woman.
What's her name?
Catherine Sable.
Is she as pretty and as smart as Miss Blake?
Well, she's more uptown, Ernie, you know what I mean? No, you don't know what I mean. Someday you'll know what I mean.
I thought you liked Miss Blake.
Well, I do, Ernie. I do, you know I do. Miss Blake, well, she's our social worker, and I can't get too social with her, if you know what I mean. Anyway, Catherine, well, she's, well, there's two kinds of women in the world, Ernie. There's the kind you get along with, and there's the kind who get along with you. You follow what I'm saying, Sport?
Not really.
Didn't Samasan cover any of this? You know, about women?
No.
Great. Nice going, Samasan. Well, Catherine has invited me to an art show at her apartment. Now, does this tie look like it wants to go to an art show?
Yeah.
Think it does?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Let's go. Patricia, do we have an appointment?
No, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by.
Uh-huh.
Do you mind if I come in?
Oh, sorry, sure, come on in.
Yeah. Hi, Ernie, hi.
Yeah,
listen,
nice.
I thought maybe if you weren't busy, the three of us could go get hamburgers, huh?
Wow, that's really nice, Patricia. Unfortunately, I've got other plans.
Oh.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I was just leaving.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. But now, Ernie, he'd like it. Wouldn't you, Ernie?
Great.
Yeah, well, like I said, I'm just leaving. You guys have a good time, all right?
Yeah, you too.
Sure, right.
Bye.
Bye now. See you.
So Mr. Rizzo has a date, huh?
Yeah, I guess so.
Good.
I'm glad you could make it.
So am I. That's a nice place you got here.
I think what you mean to say is if crime doesn't pay, defending criminals does.
No, not at all. Matter of fact, what I say, I usually mean. For instance, I'd like to say something about your eyes. I'd like to tell you how nice they go with the rest of you.
If you talked like that on the witness stand, my job would be a lot harder.
This is the part where the lady with the horns eats the lizard man.
Ernie, Mr. Rizzo told me about your nightmare. You don't want to have another one, do you?
Not from this. I've seen it four times. Whoa, look at those tentacles.
Did Mr. Rizzo say what time he was coming home?
Nobody told me not to wait up for him.
Oh. So, what do you think?
What do you think?
I have a problem. You see, I know a great deal about art, but I don't know what I like. I think I like the Impressionists better.
So do I.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite Impressionist?
Rich Little.
You are incorrigible. Do you know that?
I try.
At least you're honest enough to say what you like. Most of the people here say what I like.
You want to know what I like? I like trees that look like trees. Dogs that look like dogs. And women that look like you.
You know what? When everyone leaves, you should stay.
What are you doing, huh?
Waiting for you. Where have you been all night?
You've been waiting on the couch?
I wanted to make sure I heard you come in.
I'm surprised you weren't waiting with a rolling pin in your hand.
I was worried about you.
Why?
You were out all night.
Ernie, I'm a cop. I'm out all night a lot. You know that.
That's different.
Oh, yeah? Why?
You weren't on duty last night.
But you sure were. What are you doing?
Picking up your coat.
I can see that. Why?
You should hang your stuff up.
I do. I have my coat on the chair, my tie on the chair, my shirt on the floor. That way I know where everything is. Whoop. If I'd been out with Miss Blake, would you be doing this?
Miss Blake is different.
Well, why?
I like Miss Blake.
Well, you might like Catherine Sable, too, if you get a chance to know her.
How do you know she'd like me?
Hey, whoa. Come on. Everybody likes you. Why wouldn't she? We'll do something together real soon.
That new roller coaster's open at Fun City. It's the one where it turns upside down.
I never pay anyone to turn me upside down. Tell you what, I'll take you next weekend. I got plans tonight.
Again?
Ernie, things are going real nice between Catherine and me. Now, come on, I don't know where this is going to take me, but I like this trip so far.
Thank you.
You cannot fight the wind. It is a force you must go with and not against. This is true for kites as for life.
But it's going to get torn up.
Maybe. But it's only a kite. When a man goes against the wind, he can cause great harm to himself and perhaps to others. He must ride it until it stops blowing. He may find himself in a better place.
Jake?
Oh, Patricia. Hi. You know, I was just thinking about calling you. We haven't talked in a long time.
Yes, I know. That's why I'm here.
Well, you got that this is business, so no jokes look on your face, huh?
Yes, I am here to discuss your case.
You sure you're not here to build one against me? Right, no jokes. Okay, here we go. Here we go.
I'm worried about the amount of time you're spending away from Ernie.
Sit down. I've been out on a few dates, that's all. Ernie has been fine. He's been doing his homework, goes to visit his friend.
You've been out almost every night for a week. Now, is this going to be a pattern? Because if it is, well, we've got to talk. There's a big difference between single parent and no parent.
Hey, now, come on. You know better than that. Ernie is the most important person in my life.
Then you should include him in it.
I am. As a matter of fact, I'm taking him to dinner with me tonight at Catherine's.
You are?
Yes. She wants to meet him, and I'd like him to meet her. Just in case.
In case what?
Well, in case I need him to make a decision.
So it's that serious, huh?
No, it's not that serious. I just like to be prepared, that's all.
Yeah.
You're jealous, aren't you?
Oh, of course not. Oh, I'm a professional.
You're jealous.
If you have found someone who makes you happy and you think Ernie will be happy too, well, then I'm happy. Goodbye, Jake.
Mariposa Loop, how did you find this?
At a specialty shop down in Orchard.
Mariposa is the drink of hospitality in my homeland.
Really?
Well, when I learned you were coming, I went down to the library and did a little reading. Guess what's on the menu tonight?
All right, I give up. When's somebody going to tell me what it is we're eating?
Squid cooked with taro, oil, and spices.
In its own ink.
Oh. You can have mine. I'll get it, sure. I'll get up. Hello? Yes, Captain, yes. Yes, sir, sure, I'll be right down. Right. No, look, I'm glad I left word where I could be reached. Well, I'm sorry, duty calls. I just got a break on the tri-state car theft ring we've been looking at, and, it shouldn't be long, all right? You guys have a good time.
Don't you think it's strange that Mr. Rizzo was called away in the middle of our dinner together?
Not at all. He's a busy man. Look. Do you want the version I give the jury or the version I tell my friends?
Friends.
Okay. I wanted the time alone with you. I think that maybe you're worried about Mr. Rizzo and me, and I wanted to tell you that you don't need to be.
He really liked you. I've never seen him act this way before.
Well, thanks. That's nice to hear, but I think he'll be getting back to normal soon.
What do you mean?
Well, friendship's a funny thing, Ernie. Maybe you have a best friend, somebody you spend all your time with, somebody you play marbles with, and you think you'll never have this good a friend again. And then all of a sudden you meet someone new and you like them just as much, and suddenly, well, your old friend just isn't in the picture so much anymore.
You're dumping him already?
No, your Mr. Rizzo and I will always be friends. But I have a big case coming up back on the East Coast and some other friends I'd like to see.
Mr. Rizzo has other friends, too.
Oh, I'm sure he does. Anyway, Ernie, I just wanted to tell you that I don't think anyone will ever come between you and Mr. Rizzo, okay?
What was that?
I don't know, maybe Miss Rizzo's back.
Sweeney, so you were guilty.
You're not supposed to be here.
You know this man?
We've met. I never knew him until now. I'm calling the police.
Oh, no, you're not. You know, I'm going to need a lawyer.
Get it.
What are you doing up so late?
Thinking.
You got to do that with the lights on?
I was just thinking how nice Catherine is.
Oh.
And how nice Miss Blake is, too. But I'm not really sure which one I'm supposed to like more.
You can like them both the same if you want. But, tell you the truth, I don't think we'll be seeing much of Catherine anymore.
What?
We broke up.
Did she take it okay?
Oh, yeah, yeah, she took it fine. Actually, Ernie, she took it great. She's the one who broke it off. We had a long talk, and, well, we're really not compatible. You know, she's a bright lights, diamonds, chrome, and lucite kind of woman. I'm not a lucite kind of guy. It hurts, but it's for the best.
I'm glad. I bet Miss Blake will be glad, too.
Oh, speaking of Miss Blake, I invited her for dinner tomorrow night. You feel like cooking?
Yeah.
By the way, you know, if those guys, the motorcycles and horses, they come around tonight, just give me a shout, all right?